is about to take his fourth run. He is poised in the sixth spot. His third heat time was that of 56.69, and the start time was 5.28. His pushers, his brakemen, inside their shoe, have a little piece of paper with the start time they'd like to achieve, which is 5.22.
Well, he's got his destiny right in his hands, and he can ever pull off a magic heat. This is it. He needs a 57.30 at the bottom to stay ahead of the Soviet sled that just went down in front of him. 5.27, 100 better. Time on the left, but he's got a challenge. Ferris Boykins. He's 300 ahead going into this heat.
1956. The best finishes in Olympic competition have been fifth place. That's by Howard Seiler in 1980, and by the coach of the USA Bobsled team today, Jeff Jost, in 1984 in Sarajevo.
He's only 200 behind, and that's with a good, with a bad start. Let's watch the speed. We want to see 75 miles an hour. Yes! Oh, you've got to stay ahead of the Soviets to have any legitimate chance of a medal. Smooth, he's got the Soviet right now.
Rushlaw, you see the hands in the air by the brakeman and the pusher. This four-time Olympian and his teammates know they have produced an excellent time for this fourth heat, and they are currently in first place overall.
Tremendous time by Rushlaw. With all the controversy they've had all week long, to post those four heats, Lynn, no matter what happens, America's got to be proud of that.
You've always said that Brent Rushlaw, once he gets a lead and he's in a good position, he maintains that confidence.
Boy, he did it there. I think that's going to be a great time in this heat. Remember, everybody else comes down behind him.
Then last one.
We'll take a replay of that start. Not the start they wanted, but still good, and maybe good for this time of the day in the fourth heat.
Well, he's 100 better, and again, you improve yourself in the second heat. That's the adrenaline. That's the desire. And believe me, this team's got desire.
Watch this line. No doubt that Brent Rushlaw is a good driver.
Well, he's dealing with the cuts, and the heads aren't moving, which means he's finding a way to get through the cuts.
36 years old. Olympic destiny is on his fingertips. Up at the top, and the Austrian one sled is Peter Kienast. He was fourth overall after three heats. His time in the third heat of 56.27 was the second fastest time in that heat. He is going to challenge Wolfgang Hoppe.
Well, he's got the reputation and the personality of a gambler. And he let it all hang out in that heat and got second. So let's see what he can do here. Again, the track conditions are deteriorating. We start right out. The acceleration here at the top of the mountain is crucial. We need a great start. 5.18, there's a great start.
Fastest start of the day. Fastest start on this track was recorded yesterday at 5.15, but that 5.18 is excellent.
That is a tremendous start. Again, that's going to aid it right here at this first clock. That's Wolfgang Huffy's time at the first clock on the left. He's already lost back that great start time. The speed is the next factor. 75.1 is the best speed we've seen so far in this heat. No speed at all.
John, when we see a great start like that and a clean run and not the speed, does that tell you that the sled design may not be that fast?
That tells me the track conditions are deteriorating. I don't think you're going to have the best sled in the world to come down late in this heat. It's not going to help you one bit. The ice is chopped up. Jamaicans scraped the ice. We saw that in the crash. Look for the time here. 57.91.
57.91. He moves into fourth place overall. There's the USA team. You see they are anticipating. No one has knocked Brent Rushlaw out of second place at this moment. One of the best drivers just went down the track. They are waiting. All they can do at this point is to wait. Austria, driving the number two sled, was in fifth place overall after three heats. He needs a time here of 57.42 to move into third place. The man on the bubble in third place is USA driver number one, Brent Rushlaw. He sits, he waits with his teammates. There's nothing he can do at this point but watch Ingo Appelt and see what he can do and what he can get from this track.
Well, they had their best start of the three heats in the third heat with a 5:24. Boy, let me say the Austrians can smell a medal too. Believe me, they haven't been there since 76 themselves. 5:24 was their last start time.
He's been sliding for 6 years. Igor Opelt was a European junior champ in 85 and 86, and also the Austrian champ in 1986. John, does he have the poise and maturity to hold on to it yet?
He certainly does. He's a great pilot, very precise. His father's a jeweler. Here goes the big test. 75 mile an hour speed. 73.5. There's no speed there, Lynn. He's falling more off the pace.
Indeed, the draw and the time on this track, the weather are a factor. Fourteenth. The track slows down, the temperature is up. He's coming down in the bottom half of this track with no speed. His chances of bumping up into third place are gone.
That's it. Rushlaw still in third place.
Brent Rushlaw still in third place. As you can see, one more to go, they say. They are excited with anticipation. At the start from the Soviet Union is Yanis Kipors. He was in the third heat. He had a great start, the 5.20, 56.41. We have to keep in mind, he needs a time here of 57.86 to move up into third place in the medal contention. Right now, at the bottom of the track, Brent Rushlaw and his team are waiting. They're like an Indy 500 car that's in first place, out of gas, coasting towards the finish line with somebody with a head of steam coming right behind him. We don't know if he's going to make it or not. We have to watch Kipors.
Well, we know right off the bat their start times are going to be around a 5:20 or better. That's a great indicator.
Yes!
Adrenaline is flowing. This would be a great 2 weeks of bobsledding for Kipors to have the gold, the two-man, and the bronze, and the four-man.
Watch his start. The track is slow. We're going to have to come up with a 5.20 or 19 start. We can pay the 5:15
start.
That's the best start, equals the best start ever on this track.
Oh, the Soviets are pumped up here. Might be stealing one away from the United States with a start like that.
Of the three components needed to have a good time here, the good start, good driving ability, and the track, he has one of the three.
And he's running very clean right now. He's only 900 behind the best time. Now, the speed is important. If he gets around 74 miles an hour, that's not good for the United States medal hopes.
You see that 90? That's wrong. I think that's wrong. He can't be moving that fast.
The time on the left you're going to see is Brent Rushlaw's time. He's got to be way back from that. He's 3,900, so he's more than that.
57.86 is the time he needs to get to move into medal contention.
85! Hundredth of a second, the United States lost a medal by.
In the sport of bobsledding, I've told you on several occasions that it comes down to 1/100th of a second. In this case, 2/100ths of a second separates the Soviet team in the bronze medal and the USA finishing in fourth. Four-man bobsled comes to a close. The winner with the gold, Fosser of Switzerland, Holpe of Germany takes the silver, and Kipors of the Soviet Union has the bronze. In fourth place, best finish since 1956, Brent Rushlaw, USA sled number one, and USA sled number two in 16. But it's Eckhard Fosser of Switzerland, proving that not only could he build a sled from the ground up and make it a winner, but under tough conditions, could drive a winner. Homer wrote that victory shifts from man to man. I wonder if he just knew how fast that could happen. 2/100ths of a second, excitement to disappointment. For the Soviets, another medal to take home.
That's three Latvians and one Belarusian. And they win it third place by that much. You know, it's been Well, since the United States bobsled team won a heat, which Brent Rushlaw did today, 1952.
Ooh,